networking, like I said, anyone IEEE volunteer who an asks what is the main benefit of IEEE, network opportunities to the main factor. So this opportunity, you can connect with another volunteer who is from a completely different background, different country, different continent, or different region. You can maybe the person play the vital role for your professional growth as well. Maybe it can happen sometime, be very cautious about your network. Networking does not mean like just finding friends in social media, connecting to or replaying their story in WhatsApp or Messenger, just someone, you know, inviting them into their contact list. And networking is not that, it's completely fully different. Mainly networking is used to find out about job opportunities in their field and to increase their awareness of news, trend in their field, or in the greater world by profession to expand their circle to acquaintance. It keep up with current event in the field and develop relationship that may boost future business or employment prospects. Networking mainly the exchange of information and idea among people with a common profession or a special interest. Usually in informal social setting, networking often began with a single point of common ground. Now coming to the main point of discussion on volunteering. Before telling you how you could set your volunteering journey, how you could open your volunteering journey in IEEE, let me tell you how volunteering could help you, how volunteering in IEEE could help you in professional growth, and how volunteering in IEEE could help you in your personal growth. So volunteering provides you an opportunity to connect with your profession on who can organize the particular program. This particular webinar, it might be from different country at many of attending to their different countries. So this is an exchange for you interact to connect with people from different student branches, different section, from different countries or different region, from different continent. It's provide you the opportunity to connect with others, to build your network, and also volunteering use you an opportunity to contribute to community. It helps you expand your network and it helps you to improve yourself as an engineer. Let me tell you know how to could the set up your volunteering path. The first of all, before volunteering for any community, before not only IEEE, any community, the first identify your purpose. Why do you want to volunteering? What is that you will gain out of volunteering? What is that you want to put back to the community out in volunteering? For this, identify the purpose. Each people purpose might be different. My purpose in volunteering in IEEE might be different from that RUF areas, and your purpose of volunteering that are different. It's always good to hear about your fellow's purpose about volunteering for IEEE so that you will get an idea for choosing your purpose. Okay, so it may be anything like benefiting your local community or leveraging the skills in your local community of giving best to the community. It may be anything. You first need to identify your purpose. Why do you want to volunteer? The reason of I am expressing on this point, the laws that on which on you identify your purpose of volunteering, I think you will be able to navigate properly your volunteering journey. I start the volunteering without any purpose. There is no one tell about how to start like this webinar, how to be getting started with volunteering. I identified during the both of the time, realized myself that I was volunteering without a purpose, and then I have identified my purpose and navigate according to my purpose. So I do not hurt you here to I know to be like me that I was during my ethical period. So first of all, identify your purpose. After identify your purpose listed, you can listed your skill sheet. What are the skill you have? Maybe leadership skill, you have maybe computer skill, you have maybe electronics skill, you have maybe robotics skill, you have maybe any programming skill or any type of skill. So identify your skill set, list your skill set, what you are good at, and list out what you want to improve, and identify how you can reach these two things, how you can apply your skill, volunteer, and improve that what you are wanted to be improved. For example, I will tell you there, like I can speak very good in single room where I have no on. Before I 3 or 4 years, I speak really good. But in some period is the hair, I am not able to express my opinion. I am not be able to express that very whole. I will be strumming. I am not be, I will good where crowd is there. So if I want to like, you know, improve my speaking skill, how can I contribute as a volunteer to improving my speaking skill? Then I started to giving session in my classroom. I started to explaining horse about IEEE. I started sharing my technological skill. I started inside my classroom, then inside my student branch, then section, then region, then globally. So now I able to explain this fond of all like this. I have achieved what I wanted to achieve. Like that, you specify your skill set and you determine how you can use your skill set to volunteer for the community, and also determine how to your volunteering you can improve your skill set, you can grow your skill set and take it to the next level. The next one is identify the opportunity. Identify what are the opportunity that you have. For example, when you like speaks about like IEEE, when you ask about IEEE e-learning resource, when I ask about you IEEE e-learning, also IEEE TV, IEEE internship only, maybe on response, lots of said no. Maximum 60 or 70% said no in the chat box. So those are the opportunity to learn from e-learning library, not only e-learning library, many type of things. If you good at any special site, you can post here any content in e-learning library, also upload any document in IEEE TV, and your document would be reviewed by IEEE higher graded member. It is a kind of volunteering. It is a kind of giving back to the community. So identify the opportunities. And also IEEE Extreme 15.0, IEEE Power and Energy Society, IEEE Day Ambassador, all are the opportunity to the volunteer. Another question I want to say that here any are from IEEE Extreme 15.0 Ambassador? Okay, Irin Farjana, just on. Okay, we all learn. Irin Farjana, are you interested sharing about your experience? You can share with us something. Just IEEE Extreme 15.0, your ambassador experience. Also Akshaya. Akshaya, are you interested in sharing about your experience? Just for 30 seconds.
Yeah, actually, hello Tabil. So I was just selected this year. So I'm just really marketing and spreading the awareness about what IEEE actually is and the importance of the IEEE Extreme when it comes to a student, and what are all the opportunities and how can one increase their technical capabilities and all such kinds. So that is what we are doing right now. So I'm not completed my, I mean, I didn't complete my entire thing. I'm just learning. I'm also learning as well, and trying to create an awareness more to the student community.
Okay, great. Thank you for sharing ideas. Then next is mentorship. Identify your opportunity like that, your underline. If you are only an IEEE member without part of any technical society, identify the opportunity. If you are already member of any society like Power and Energy Society, Industry Automation Society, Computer Society, Robotics and Automation Society, Signal Processing Society, then talk about any senior person, take advice from them. They will give to you a lots of opportunity at this site. Always ask for help, always. Find a senior volunteer who could give you, guide you into the right path, get mentorship from them. After a few years, you can convert your experience to your junior. Then apply. Apply is a vital for volunteering, but it has just two parts. One part is not selected, and another is you have not at all to apply for the program. After two or before 2-5 minutes, I just say that, are you from any IEEE Extreme volunteer? But only two, but others say the maximum said is just no. You have only 2 points on page you are applied but not selected. Another is you have to not and apply for the program. Okay, you need to always apply for any opportunity. When you get call IEEE Day or IEEE Power Energy Society Day or IEEE Extreme like this, just apply. And also when you call from any conference volunteer, just apply. Never ignore that. Don't worry about your rejection. Sometimes you will get extension, sometimes you will chance, and sometimes you will be rejected. Sometimes we may overconfident about our skill, but this type of rejection are way to telling that no, you need to be improved. When you rejected, don't get demotivated. You apply for next time. One day, hopefully your opportunity will click. Always remember that, I again say, always remember that they reject your just application, not you. They reject your application. So only your application is rejected, you have a chance for improving your application, then again try on your opportunity will click. This next one is training. Training like and volunteering, we have different things like to be part of advertising, you can to be part of content team, you can be part of report writing team, you can be like part of designing team, videography team. There are many type of interesting volunteering position available. You will need to choose your position, what you are good at. Whether you are good at reaching out the people and promoting an event, whether you are good at designing poster or you are good at flyer, you decide what you are good at. That's why I said identify your skill and knowledge. You decide what you are good and take training accordingly. When you are training in your volunteering time, you feel that you need to be upgrade the section. Then take the training. And main question is how can you take the training? You can take the training e-learning library IEEE TV. And another thing is lots of student bears who are organizing training program. For example, today Sinem Engineering College IEEE Computing Society chapter organizing this program for volunteer that how to know they can start IEEE volunteering. There may be separate many other student brands who organize a designing workshop, web development workshop, content writing workshop. So you can participate in this workshop. This kind of workshop or webinar, seminar would be completely free. Many 90 or 80% webinar workshop are free for IEEE member many of the time. So utilize the opportunity and get training, upskill yourself. And also you can get ASIP certificate from there. And at last on it, this volunteering part, commitment. Commitment is the very important, like you should be knowing whether you will be able to views and volunteering opportunities that you are taking. There are several volunteers who take every opportunity that come into their hands. Like they may be coming fifth or sixth position after time. They would be volunteering fifth or sixth position, multiple position. It is standing too much pressure in your head. Don't do that. Never do that. This always always remember that on time, maybe it's 60% people present here, okay, 58. So always remember that when you apply for volunteering, you are not applying for any volunteering opportunity at whoever someone approaching you to volunteer for anything. Remember on at time. Whether you are already volunteering any position and then anything are you will be going. Be able to giving your time new opportunity that is approaching to you. You took those opportunity very wisely. Do not take multiple opportunities. Do not into your pocket. Such as if you are already volunteering for something and if somebody is again coming approach you any new position, always kind of enough to pass the opportunity to anyone who is seeking for that opportunity. Today maybe 20 people are take position, but 40 people has not any type of position. So many people do not do that. Many people take, okay, when you are already a member, you are an already volunteer and any type of organization is say that are you interested in a volunteer position, they say okay, I will do it and they used to take it. Sometimes it is good to say no for sometimes opportunity, and sometimes it is very very good to pass down opportunity to another volunteer who is willing to volunteer for them. Be very sure your commitment. You are volunteer and you can volunteer only during our free time, so should also be considering your the academic commitment, your personal commitment. Also choose your volunteering opportunity accordingly. Because only if you choose on position at the time, only if you are volunteering on position at the same time, you will be able to give your best that position. But you take 3, 4, 5, or 6, just hold 6 position and only hold you. And it's much too much pressure for you, and you not will be the best for this time. And you will not able to give your best in this position, the 5 or 6 position. Just on position is best. And you can forward this position for other member who are seeking for this volunteer position. Also, you will be able to learn a lot of volunteering for this position. Else you cannot concentrate on too many things. You will be missing the learning is that you have ends the every opportunity. So choose your opportunity very wisely and be sure your commitment before choosing any position. So like this, you always to be a source of opening a volunteering opportunity for others, and you can think change the in others this way. Always remember this step, this 7 step, okay? This way, always remember 7 steps I told you. If you are a new volunteer, it's identify helps you. Okay, so happy volunteering. Thank you so much, Dr. Soma ma'am, also Narshini, for inviting me. And also in your language, maybe thank you, Mikka Nandri.